fishing that it is described as unspoiled. The description fits Coverack better than most. While time has not stood still, it has not inflicted much change on this tiny community. It's surprising, really, because its sheltered beach of sand and shingle is a magnet for holidaymakers and day trippers. The sheltered harbour has changed little over the years and still caters for working fishermen rather than pleasure boats. The narrow streets are lined with attractive whitewashed cottages. And there are more than a few thatched roofs on show. A handful of shops and cafes are housed in old buildings rather than modern structures of glass and plastic. The old post office is a post office no more. But it makes an attractive cottage overlooking the harbour. There's only one pub, and although the Paris dates only from 1907, its origins go back to earlier times. It takes its name from a steamship which was wrecked on the rocky coastline nearby in 1899. The old lifeboat station, which is more than 100 years old, is now a restaurant. But on the harbour wall nearby, there are notice boards which tell the proud story of that lifeboat station and the lives it saved between 1901 and 1978 when it was closed. The heart of the village is, of course, around the harbour. And whether the tide is in or out, it's an attractive spot to linger a while and look at the boats. A short distance away is St. Peter's Church, which dates from 1885, when it was built at a cost of £500. Coverack's only hotel is the Bay, which has a commanding position overlooking the beach. But it's only a short distance from North Cornwall, the posh end of the village, where there are houses which can change hands for £1 million or more. The other end of the village has cottages which may be less grand, but are a picturesque reminder of the area's past. At Christmas, Coverack is famous for its festive lights, which are erected and paid for by local people. And on Christmas Day morning, the village is invaded by hundreds of people who watch or take part in the annual swim in the harbour. The swimmers may be outnumbered by spectators, but whatever the weather, the event always raises a good sum for charity. A few miles inland from Coverack is Roskilly's Farm, where in addition to sampling delicious cream teas or ice cream, you can wander around a small lake rich in wildlife. A short distance along the cliff path from the village is a unique sculpture park, where sculptor Terence Coventry has created a collection of artworks which surely must have startled a few unsuspecting walkers on a dark evening. Yellow paint on the roads is an indication that Coverack, unchanged and uncommercialised as it is, attracts plenty of visitors in the summer. remains a living community, and as such will change, but it retains much of the character it must have had in the days of old,